This week, I'm going up to Bete Grise, Michigan, because there is a legend I really want to investigate. The legend of the singing sand. As the legend goes, a Native American woman, probably an Ojibwe woman given the area, once lost her lover to Lake Superior. She tragically spent the rest of her life crying out to him, and now, in her absence, the sand also sings to him. But here's the part I'm really curious about. According to the story, if you remove the sand from the beach, it loses its ability to sing. I want to know if that's true, and if it is, I want to know why. I also want to learn why this beach sings in the first place. So let's take a drive and go find out.
I mean, what's the point of driving all the way up here if you're not going to stop and look at the volcanic cliffs? Someday I will make a video about you. But for now, I got a beach to go to.
We made it to Bete Grise. It is a little bit windy out here, but it is absolutely stunning. I mean, look at this view. This place is so great.
Okay, well, one thing I can tell you is this is some really nice quality sand. Also, I just want to say, do not be deceived by how nice and pleasant the water looks. It is, okay, here we go. Oh, that is extremely cold.
Okay, so I actually did a little bit of research before coming out here because I wanted some context for what I was going to experience at this beach. Because I've been to a fair number of beaches around the United States and also around the state of Michigan, and I do know that singing sand is a thing. On some beaches, if you kick the sand or run your hand through it, it makes this noise that's been described as like singing or squeaking or barking, and you know, I think all of those are probably fair. Actually, come to think of it, before I keep talking, I should probably make sure this beach actually does sing. So let's go figure that out. So I'm just gonna find a smooth spot. Okay, that's some good looking sand. Let's see if it makes noise. Oh, thank goodness. I do want to say that noise might not sound like a ton, but it doesn't happen on all beaches.
Like, I'm now at another beach several miles away, and the sand sounds like nothing. Yeah, no, just sounds like sand.
Okay, good news. The singing sand is actually a thing, and now I can tell you a bit about why. So for that, I'm going to shoot you back to my living room.
Oh hey, so a surprising number of people have looked into this, and although I don't think the scientific community like 100% agrees on the answer, there is pretty substantial evidence for one explanation. The key thing with singing sand is that the grains of sand have to be pretty close to spherical, and they also have to be uniform in size. They also can't be too big or too small. One paper found that they need to be somewhere in the ballpark of like a third of a millimeter across, in case you're curious. Just to add to that pile, the sand also can't be too wet, and it also can't be super packed down by a bunch of people walking on it, which actually might be part of why Bete Grise is such a good beach for this. Side note, you can revive singing sand, and actually one of the ways researchers have done that totally cracked me up, so I wanted to share. In this paper, the researchers had packed their sand down a bunch as part of their experiments, so it no longer made noise, and they wanted to restore its singing ability to keep working. So what they did is they washed the sand in water, okay, cool, but then they washed it in two types of acid, boiled it for several hours, and then let it dry. I mean, it worked. They don't say why it worked, but I have the slightest suspicion it might have been overkill. Anyway, so you've got these round, uniformly sized grains of sand. Then when you hit the sand or run your hand through it, what you're doing is you're displacing the sand grains. You're taking some of the sand and you're shoving it into other sand. When you do that, friction between those equally sized sand grains causes vibrations. Then those vibrations make the air vibrate, which reaches your eardrum. And then if you're a hearing person, you hear something that sounds like a squeak or a bark or a song, depending on who you ask.
What a good day to be a family of geese. Now, here's the part of the legend I don't really understand. According to the story, if you remove the sand from the beach, it should stop making noise. But that just doesn't make sense to me. If the reason sand sings is based on the size and shape of the grains and variables like that, I don't understand why taking it away from the beach would make any difference. But I got time, I got sand, and I've got a good deal of curiosity about this. So let's see if that part of the legend's true.
Just gonna take some sand and zhuzh it into the bowl. Try not to get the wet stuff. This is a good dry pile. I have hope that sand makes sense.
Okay, I got some sand.
This feels like the setup for the weirdest cooking show on the internet, but okay, Here we go. I've got the same rock that I used to make the sand squeak, and I've got two containers of sand from the same area. One is in a larger glass bowl with some more surface area, and the other one is in just your standard plastic leftovers container because, I don't know, sand and glass are made of kind of similar things, so I wasn't sure if that would be a confounding variable. But, legend of the singing sand. According to the legend, if you take the sand off the beach, it loses its ability to sing. Let's see if there's any truth to that. All right. Ah! That is a good squeak, my friends. It still works. Trial number two. Oh! That's even louder. It totally still works. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and dump these containers of sand out. The reason I did this in bowls, I suppose like a logical next step to the experiment would be to take the sand home, like physically take it away from the beach. I think you could argue that that's also what the legend says, but sand is super important to ecosystems. So I'm gonna leave it here. Okay, so we ran some tests. We found out that the sand squeaks on the beach. The sand also squeaks if you remove it from the beach and put it in a couple of containers. I mean, in good scientific fashion, I can tell you that my hypothesis was that the sand would still squeak if you took it off the beach because the sand grain size and shape and all that were still the same. And I can tell you that my experiment supported that hypothesis. That's what I know. Man, one way or another, this was super fun. And thanks for tagging along. I hope this was interesting for you. I hope you learned something cool and just thanks for being here. If you're interested in supporting the work I do and helping me make more things like this, especially things that require me to travel, there are two ways you can do that. One is to just share this video with a friend or on social media if you enjoyed it. It's a small thing, but it does really make a huge difference. And the other thing is that I actually just launched a Patreon recently. If you're not familiar with Patreon, it's a really simple, straightforward way to financially support people who make things. And if you want to learn more about that, you can find more information at patreon.com/AlexisDahl. Either way though, I'm glad you're here. This was a blast. I'm already looking forward to doing it again, and I'll see you next time.